Hi guys, I am about to do my first, I gotta figure out how to get in here. Okay, I was gonna do a little getting ready with me moment. I am in my childhood bathroom in Alabama, which is like the size of three of my New York bathrooms put together. So I just took a shower. I took my tape and extensions out a few days ago, so my hair is now drying really quickly. And then I washed and conditioned my clip-ins since I'll be using those in between my tape-ins. So my hair is almost dry now. The first thing I did was I spray tanned, which I'm out of spray tan in New York, but there was some here, which makes me really happy. And I don't even know if they make this anymore. It is like old as the hills, but I haven't done any sort of spray tan or anything else. No tanning beds, no anything like that in a long time. And I'm looking very pasty. I think that is, okay, that was the mirror that was reflecting. It looks pretty good. So let's see, first thing I do when I'm getting ready for a night out, obviously, I'm gonna pour some wine. This is what my dad likes. It's pretty good. Have you ever heard of it? Had it? Mayumi Pinot. Gets the job done. And let's see. And then obviously I like to put music on. So let's see, on Spotify we have your top songs 2020. So let's see what that is. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. I listened to that song about 500 times. All right, so let's get started. I'm really not that high maintenance a getting ready person, which you would not believe from the hair extensions. At least when my tape-ins are in, I'm really fast. But these are all the products that I traveled with, and that includes my Dyson, which I could not live without. So I guess since my hair is just about dry and I need to make sure it doesn't get all kinky, I am going to do a little Dyson dry. If this would actually go in here. Oh no, it got bent. Travel. Okay, there we go. So typically when I have my tape ends in, I have to dry the bonds first. So I use this to do that, but that is like totally pointless right now. So then I use this one to get some body in my hair. I'm like already getting like purple teeth. I hate that. Why I don't drink wine normally. But there are limited options here in Alabama, y'all. So this is like, I don't even know if it's this kind of thickening spray. It's some sort of spray that's supposed to give me volume. I have such little hair and it's fine and limp and boring. So I do that. And then we'll get moving. This is like not the best tutorial. I'm way better at doing this with my extensions in. But as far as clip-ins go, I have found that they do better when you let them air dry because they kind of feel more like real hair and less like kind of plasticky and processed. So, all right, looks like that's all the volume I'm getting. This is definitely not meant to be a tutorial. I'm definitely not good at like most things getting ready. This is literally just what I do. So. Basically, you're just kind of hanging out. And then I obviously put some heat protector in my baby fine hair. I mean, it's already like so dry, this probably isn't gonna work. But I will show you the Dyson magic as much as I can. And how do people do these get ready with me things? They look so like smooth and perfect the whole time. So that's why this is my first attempt at it. That reminds me, I need to do my face prep. Okay, Dyson. Bam. So when you think about the Dyson hair drying set, you're like, oh my gosh, it's so much, it's so many pieces. I only travel with the base, this one, because it has things that go both directions. I'm like, I'm not gonna like switch it over. So I
I can get away with just traveling with both of these, especially if it's just my natural hair. So I just kind of do the same thing like a curling iron. And I turn them upside down. And then it has like this really easy button that you just, when it's on, you just go up like that, and then it does the cool air, so it kind of sets the curls. And then for it to go the right direction over here. Oh my gosh, why does my hair suck so much? I hate it. Oh yeah, this is another good song of 2020. I mean, at least like music was okay, right? All right, do this last little guy. Curls, they are so cute. So sometimes what I do is I will work my extensions in while I'm drying it, so it blends nicely. So that means, yeah, probably right here. Is that the long one? Yeah, it's a long one. A little wet for my taste, but let's see. No. We'll try it. If it doesn't work, I'll just take it back out. So I'm gonna go right above that like first section. I would normally like tease my hair a little bit, but I don't feel like doing that right now. So then I can take my little sections from the extension. It's okay if a little bit of your hair gets in there. And then I just like my tape ends, I do that. Extensions curl so much better than actual hair. It's insane. Also, when you get ready, dancing around is a must. So, most important note. Okay, so before I get back to the hair, as soon as you get out of the shower, put on your products, your face products. So this is my eye stuff, it's my fave, Peyton Company. I talk about it all the time. It goes on really smoothly, smells like cucumbers, makes you happy. So depending on your skin, I don't know, I like using, well, this kind of just went all over my face, a little oil and letting it soak in while I'm kind of starting on my hair, obviously way before foundation, but kind of doing it on the really dry parts, and it'll A, soak in, and then when you put your foundation on, it won't like get that kind of dry, crusty feeling, especially in the winter, and it doesn't like go into your wrinkles, all of your wrinkles, all of them, just like all of my wrinkles. Just kidding, I look great. Okay, so, let's see. Also a good one. I'm making a video, Mom.
warranty?
Yes.
Are you almost done?
With my video?
Video?
Yeah, I'm making a getting ready video. I've never looked back my hair. This looks pretty great.